just a random security check.
Random, huh?
No. Come on, just do what the guy says.
You were racist?
Racist? Dude, I'm black.
He's black. He's not racist.
Please. You're barely even brown.
We're actually here with the writers and directors of the new Harold and Kumar movie, John Hurwitz and Hayden Schlossberg. Now, did I get that right?
Yes.
Oh, there we go. All right, guys, so you wrote the first Harold and Kumar movie, did not direct it. However, this time around, you're directing the movie. So how did that process come about?
It was great. We were on set the entire time for the first Harold and Kumar film. Danny Liner, who directed the first movie, was great to us. I mean, a lot of writers, they just get tossed to the curb once their script is in there. But Danny was really collaborative with us. We were on set the whole time. We got to work with the actors the first time around. So that when we wrote the sequel and Danny was unavailable to direct it, there was really nobody better to step in than the two of us. And even though we had absolutely no directing experience before this film, we had a lot of Harold and Kumar experience.
You knew the characters.
We knew the characters. We knew the actors. And, you know, these movies are our vision. You know, this is something that, you know, we love these characters. We love the world that they prance around in. So it was great to be able to carry out the entire process, together.
Sometimes the world you wish you lived in, huh?
Yeah.
No, me too.
Except for Guantanamo. Don't want to live in there.
Definitely. Sure. God, I hope it's not really like that. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you guys have some inside information or something.
We did a lot of research, and what you see in Harold and Kumar's Escape from Guantanamo Bay is exactly what goes on in Guantanamo.
Yes.
Exactly.
I don't think many people realize that at least one of these characters comes from a real person.
There's
a real Harold Lee.
The real Harold Lee. I was born in New Jersey, and then I moved to Pittsburgh for 7 years. I lived in a suburb outside of Pittsburgh called Upper St. Clair from first through seventh grade, and I met a young boy there then in my class, Harold Lee. And he and I became friends then, and then I moved to New Jersey where Hayden and I actually met in high school, but then after that I went to college. Harold and I reunited in college, and you know the three of us spent a lot of time together over the years.
I would visit him at college, and we'd all hang out and have fun, and it was crazy because every time we would go out with Harold Lee, people would shout MILF, at him. They all thought that he was John Cho from American Pie, and so that's really kind of when we first started to pay attention to John Cho. We were like, everybody keeps calling our friend the MILF guy. And so even before we wrote Harold and Kumar, we knew, hey, there is an actor out there that might be perfect for this guy, Harold.
And it worked out, right?
Yeah.
Well, eventually Harold went with it and just pretended to be John Cho. So if there are any rumors of illegitimate children from John Cho, it's probably the real Harold.
That's what we call an exclusive here.
Exactly.
Only a sneak peek.
No one else knows.
All right, now guys, a little serious here, but obviously the film does explore a lot of stereotypes that a lot of minorities face, and actually, puts stereotypes on a lot of Caucasian Americans, like, you know, anyone you can imagine. Right. Was that a point that you wanted to make, you know, especially coming from Hollywood?
Yeah, I think it's really important in these movies for us to, you know, to break stereotypes for every single culture and to poke fun at everybody. And that, you know, if you're only making fun of a certain people, it could be viewed as mean-spirited, whereas if everything is politically incorrect to everybody, then it just somehow is accepted. So
just go with it.
Yeah, you just go with it. And I think that, you know, when you watch the movie, it's almost like a comedy roast of every single culture out there. And we've seen it with some test audiences. And there's moments where, you know, some of the black characters in the film are dealing with racism, and the black people in the audience are going crazy and just loving it. And you know,
you see that with each group, you know,
something for every minority.
Exactly.
Well, I mean, you guys, you're givers, you know, and you want to be fair, and I respect that. But thank you very much. Really appreciate your time. I really enjoyed the movie. Can't wait till it comes out and everyone can see it.
Awesome.
Yep.
Awesome.
Thanks,
appreciate
guys.
It.
Back to you.